As spring prepared to give way to summer, the full bucket line became busier and busier. The Southern Pacific had built a new branch line to Thomas Canyon. The line was also built to service a new industrial park that began construction after World War II. The locomotives themselves were relieved that the branch line was almost finished. Mr. Iverson assigned extra work to get the supplies that the workers required to build the new branch line. On the second day of summer, the line will be completed, and an inaugural train will begin its first run. All the Southern Pacific engines had gathered at Fort Fairfax early to receive their work orders from Mr. Iverson. It was the last day of spring, and the locomotives still had loads that needed to go to the branch line before it could open. The sun had just begun to rise, and Eric watched the sky change colors.
The sunrise this morning is beautiful. What could possibly ruin this moment? I just had to say it.
Eric, look at that.
Nothing anymore.
All right, settle down now. Before I give you all your work orders, I have some news. You all have worked very hard the past couple of weeks, but your work is not over yet. Not only is the branch line to Thomas Canyon opening 2 days from now, Mr. Mercer is sending our railway inspector out to conduct our annual inspection.
Great. Another railway inspector. I think this is the last thing we need to worry about.
As I was saying, these next couple of days will be very hard, especially with Luke getting repaired. All of you will have to work overtime to get the branch line done and to do Luke's job, especially you, Tyler.
This day just got worse.
We'll be here all day if you don't let me finish. Anyways, Tyler, you'll have to pull the bucket liner daylight from LA all the way to Salt Lake City until Luke gets back. Understand?
Yes, sir.
All right, then. Here are today's work orders. Tyler, you'll be taking a fuel train to L.A., and then you'll be picking up the bucket liner.
Yeah, I got it.
Right then. Now, Larry, you see that heavy freight train over there? It needs to go to Phoenix. After you deliver that train, the Phoenix Yardmaster will have your next set of orders.
Not enjoy it. Consider it done, boss.
All right, Jimmy. You're taking the Simonville Cannonball to Dunktown. Take it easy, because you'll have a work train attached behind your coaches. Drop the work train off at the branch line and continue on with your local stops.
Get right on it, sir.
Hold on a minute, Eric. After that, you'll meet the new engine that'll be serving the Thomas Canyon. Bring him back here, okay?
Yes, sir.
Remember, his name is Daniel, and he's a...
Yeah, I got it, sir.
Wait a minute! Hold on a minute, Eric! I know I never had any kids.
Thank you.
didn't see any of the Southern Pacific engine. All he saw was an old American class locomotive. Eric decided to ask the old timer if he knew where the new engine was.
Excuse me, sir.
What do you want?
I was wondering if you've seen any other locomotives.
No, I wasn't happy until you came along.
I'm sorry. I was looking for the new Thomas Canyon engine.
What's wrong with me?
Well, you're...
Is that what you wanted to say?
No. I was going to say that you're not a Southern Pacific locomotive.
Now listen to me, you whippersnapper. Don't judge a book by its cover. I just happen to be the locomotive you're looking for. But rather than asking if I was the new Thomas Canyon locomotive, you chose to not believe that I couldn't be the locomotive you were looking for.
I'm sorry.
I don't care for your apologies. Just show me where to go.
Yes, sir.
Air quickly brought the new engine back to Fort Fairfax. He felt very silly, but at the same time, he thought the new engine was very rude. When Eric and Daniel arrived at Fort Fairfax, they went straight to Mr. Iverson's business card.
Ah, Mr. Iverson. It's a pleasure to meet you.
It is nice to finally meet you as well, Daniel. I assume your trip here was nice?
Well, it's the farthest I've ever traveled, but everything went smoothly.
Well, you have already met Eric, and you'll meet the other engines later. But now, you have some work to do.
What orders do you have for me, sir?
Okay. You need to take supplies down to Thomas Canyon lobby. Do you need Eric to show you?
No, I know where to go. Thank you, Mr. Iverson.
You're welcome. So, Eric, what do you think of Daniel?
Sir, are you sure that Daniel can service the Thomas Canyon line all by himself?
Eric, I can understand why would you think that, but Daniel is a very reliable engine.
But sir, how can a 100-year-old engine handle modern trains?
Well, we'll have to see for ourselves, won't we?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, you have to take the Pacific for the express to Bucket Springs. You have top priority since this train is on a tight schedule. Don't worry about other engines. Mr. Willsman and Mr. Struthead okay your trip.
Yes, sir. I'll get right on it.
After a half an hour of maintenance, Eric quickly got the Pacific Route Express and headed for Bucket Springs. But it wasn't long until he had to stop. A signal on the outskirts of town was red, and Eric could not proceed. The brakeman climbed down from his cab and walked up the tracks to see what the problem was.
What is going on up there? If we don't get moving, this train will be late and the produce will spoil.
Eric learned soon enough. The brakeman came back, climbed into the cab, and talked to the engineer. After a few minutes, the signal turned green and Eric was off. As he neared the entrance to the Thomas Canyon line, he noticed Daniel pulling the work train, but his wheels were slipping and couldn't get a good grip.
I knew Daniel wasn't up for the job.
After a 2-hour run across the Nevada desert, Eric finally arrived in Bucket Springs and was right on schedule. As soon as he was uncoupled from the train, the yard manager told him to go to Lakehurst to pick up passenger cars for the Thomas Canyon line. When Eric arrived, the passenger cars were nowhere to be seen, so he decided to go to the Union Pacific engine shed to ask where the cars were. When he got there, he was relieved to find Connor getting washed down.
Hey, Eric. What brings you to inside the yard?
Well, I was wondering where the new Thomas Canyon coaches were.
Oh, those. Ted should be bringing them for those end any minute now.
Thanks, Connor. Why aren't you working today?
I was supposed to be hauling a coal train out to Cheyenne, but an airplane fell, so the train is held up while the airplane is installed.
Well, I hope you get your train soon.
Yeah. Me too.
Sounds like my train's here. See ya, Connor. It was nice talking to you.
Thanks for coming over. Bye.
Eric made his way over to the main line. Ted pulled in with the coaches behind him, but they were very different than the coaches Eric was accustomed to. These coaches were very old, and appeared to be old as Daniel.
Here are your coaches, loser.
Ted, get lost.
Be careful. Spark might set them ablaze.
God, I hate that guy. They should push him off a cliff.
Eric was soon hooked up to the passenger cars and was ready to head out, but already a problem had occurred. His brake hoses weren't compatible to the hoses on the coaches.
Great. What are we supposed to do now?
Well, Eric, Ted must have taken the adapter. I guess we'll have to apply brakes the old-fashioned way.
Can't we just get the adapter?
And risk losing our slot? We'll just have to use the brake wheels.
This trip is gonna take forever.
Eric soon left the yard. The brakeman had opened up all the doors to the passenger cars, so that way he could quickly run through them to apply the brakes. Eric was only allowed to travel 40 miles per hour, and that irritated him. He finally made it back to Fort Fairfax, and after shunning the coaches away in a siding, Eric went to get some rest. He fell asleep quickly, but he didn't sleep that long.
I surrender!
What's all the screaming about, whippersnapper?
Daniel, my name is Eric. Why did you wake me up?
The sun is still up, so you should still be awake.
Listen, I've had a long day, and I'm really tired.
I've had a long day too, but you don't see me complaining. All of you new superpower locomotives are just a bunch of whiners. If you're superpowered, then you should be working longer than I do. Now get moving!
Why didn't you tell me what to do?
Why? Because I'm your elder.
Eric left him huffing, and he went off to find Mr. Iverson's business card. When he found Mr. Iverson, he was talking to the railway inspector.
Eric, just the engine I was looking for. This is the railway inspector. I was gonna have Daniel pull the inspection caboose, but it seems that you're not busy. All you have to do is pull the caboose up to Dunktown and back. Then Daniel will take the train up to Thomas Canyon. I figured that we would get the track inspection done today while all the engines are busy.
Yes, sir. Mr. Inspector, get ready to leave.
The sun was setting as Eric headed the inspection train. The journey was simple. Traveling round trip between Fort Fairfax and Dunktown, Eric made sure that he followed all the speed restrictions and that he gave the inspector a smooth ride. As the night sky began to appear, Eric headed into the Fort Fairfax yard. He was beginning to doze off. It had been a long day. But overall, Eric was pleased that his work was finally done. He was hoping for a nice rest. Unfortunately, his moods changed. There, at the entrance of the yard, was Daniel looking very unhappy.
Finally, you're back.
Come on, I wasn't gone that long.
Stop whining and give me the caboose.
Daniel, I've had enough of your orders. I know what I'm doing, but it's not good enough for you. All you do is yell and boss me around. I'm sick of it. I don't understand why Mr. Iverson even bought you. Wait, Daniel! Wait! I didn't mean it!
But it was too late. Eric had no choice but to pull the inspection caboose up to Thomas Canyon himself.
We'll go slow.
Slowly moved down the branch line. The track began to grow. The rails were not designed to hold up locomotive as heavy as Eric, since the line did not require a locomotive his size. He began to work and hoped that the line held up his weight.
I agree with you there.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. Come on.
Well, looks like the tracks gave way, causing us to derail. The worst part is, the wheels and the rods got damaged on the impact. We're not going anywhere now.
Now what?
We'll have to phone for help.
Eric was worried. The only engine available besides Daniel was Jimmy. Jimmy was probably light enough to prevent the rails from cracking, but the combined weight of Jimmy and Eric would be a disaster. Eric's driver called Fort Fairfax and relayed the news to Mr. Iverson. The driver hung up and told Eric and the fireman what the plan was.
Guys, Mr. Iverson's very annoyed with us. He says the opening will probably have to be postponed. He sent Jimmy to get new rails and workers, but the crane is up at Thomas Canyon, so we're stuck here until another crane can be acquired.
I wish Daniel was here. He'd know what to do.
Eric's fire was dropped, and he waited for Jimmy. He felt very foolish, and he knew his punishment would be very severe. As Eric sat, a light appeared in the distance.
What is that?
I don't know.
Believe it! It's Daniel!
What kind of trouble have you gotten yourself into now, Whippersnapper?
Boy, am I glad to see you. I'm sorry about what I said earlier.
Eric, I was being unreasonable. You know, I was acting the way I did so you guys wouldn't dismiss me as an old tankhead. I'm sorry I irritated you and got you into this mess.
Well, it's mostly my fault. I should have listened to you because you're wiser than me. After I saw you struggling with the train earlier today, I thought that you belonged in a museum and shouldn't be telling strong mainline engines what to do.
Struggling? Me? Never. The workers spilled oil and I couldn't get an ounce of traction. I think we misunderstood each other.
Well, I'm glad that you're here. They don't build engines as late as you anymore. If not for you, I would have been stuck here.
Well, I guess my age does benefit me in a way.
So, are we friends?
Yes, we're friends.
Cool.
By morning, the workers had reinforced all the track between Eric and the main line. Eric was finally rerailed, and after the track was repaired, Daniel pulled Eric and the inspection caboose back onto the main line. Jimmy took Eric and the caboose back to Fort Fairfax as Daniel pushed the work train back up to Thomas Canyon. Finally arrived at the yard, Mr. Iverson was waiting.
Eric, I'm very disappointed with you. You didn't think, and now we have to send you to be repaired. Now we're two engines short, and the grand opening will have to be postponed. The inspector is probably going to fine us because of your accident.
Sorry, sir.
All right. Since I can't afford to lose another engine to take you to the works, Captain Bodie is coming by to pick you up. Now, if you excuse me, I have to go and clean up your mess.
Yes, sir.
Eric sat in the yard until the next day at noon when Captain Bodie came by. The captain asked him about the accident, and Eric told him the entire story.
Well, that's quite a story.
Yeah, the worst part is that Mr. Iverson is now down by two engines.
Really? That's terrible.
Hopefully the other engines won't be too overworked.
No, I wouldn't worry about that.
A week later, Eric's wheels and rods were finally repaired, and he was racing back to Fort Fairfax with a mixed freight. We'll be right back.
Why isn't everybody working? What happened?
Calm down, Eric. Nothing happened.
But how? Why?
Eric, while you were gone, we got some help.
From who? You told Captain Bodie that we were two engines short. The entire full bucket line police force came to help out. With the extra power, we were able to get all of our work in and on time.
The best part is, with the help, we were able to focus more on the branch line and we were able to open it on time.
Wow, I guess my mistake helped.
That may be true, but just never do it again, okay, Eric?
Yes, sir.
Eric learned his lesson, and the Southern Pacific engines fell back into their routine. They all knew that Daniel was a very good friend, and when it comes to wisdom, well, the older is definitely the better.